Friend Bob came over today, it's like 90 degrees out, and handed me the washers, they're all set. He threw them on the lathe and drilled them out to 5/8. So I just gotta put the acorn nuts on, but I have to pull this top plate off at some point, and there's some things I gotta do. Like, I never put grease on any of these bearings on the trees. I gotta clean up this black off of here or put something around it, I don't know what. Maybe wrap it in, I was thinking about wrapping it in red and black parachute cord. And with my fan, that's what keeps screwing up my microphone. Oh, it's so hot today, and it's got to be 90 just standing here in this place. So I'm gonna call it a day for today. We'll do something else tomorrow. We got some stuff done. Oh, I went to the flea market. I got a, what the hell did I do with it? Oh, I got a Craftsman swivel ratchet for $5. And I got three packs of these quarter 20 taps. There's three quarter 20 taps in here. And all three. It's 3, 6, 9 for it was $10. I could beat that. I use these things all the time at work and all the time at home. I gotta put my cheater glasses in my pocket here. This is something. I'm sorry. This is something Hank, my friend Hank, had made quite a few years ago. But I think I'm gonna use it. I don't know where yet. I think I'll have him powder coat it and polish it. It says Manfred von Richthofen, the Red Baron. And I was thinking it would be cool, like right here. Because that's what it's about. But, nothing today. I'm gonna clean up my mess. I'm gonna push this thing outside for now. How clean are these, right? Yeah, you can almost eat off the things. I'm sure the assembly lube tastes a little nasty. All that with a wire brush. That's awesome. Well, I think what I'm going to do is mess with the intake manifold, pull it over here, tape it up, and paint these in a high heat black. The runners for the intake. And mask it off, since this is all silver. Give or take a little speck of rust. Looks good. I do that right now. Now I have high heat black runners. This one's still wet. So I'm going to hang this thing up for a while, let it dry, and move on. Now this is the intake runners and the intake ends and the heat exchanger. Did a little fade of silver, who cares? And these are all powder coated blood red, look really good. This is just silver and this is high heat black. And I wish it wasn't in the sun so much, but it's that time of day. Mine does have the vacuum tube on this. It's kind of unusual it has that. Not many did. I believe that was a fuel injection thing. It can be used for the distributor, I believe, as a vacuum advance, but I don't have that. And I do have this, so I gotta cap this one off, and I gotta cap this one off. But these look really sweet. I don't know if you can see the red. Kind of shining in the sun quite a bit. Brand new booties. Mine was so dried up and ripped, it wasn't even funny. And I made it so the screwdrivers are on the screwdriver heads are on the front. They're flat heads for the clamps. These slide only so far onto here, and then this kind of locks into it, and then just keeps a seal between the two. But pretty cool idea. This is actually the back side of the intake, so let's go to the other side. Maybe the sun will help instead of hinder. So the intake is silver and looking good. I don't have a carburetor. The carburetor I have is a rusty piece of crap. It would take a lot to clean it. It's actually right there in that bucket. sitting in that cleaning fluid. Maybe we rebuild it, maybe we won't, we'll see. I'm going to see if I can find something to cap this off and cap that off, or I'm going to be buying a little plug kit to do it. Okay, still having fun. This is my current lawnmower. We got this thing last year. It works okay. No problem with it. This is that one I got for free the other day with me and Bob were riding around, and I told you the story. This is pretty cool. But this thing didn't have any forward pull. It was slipping. I just had to loosen this screw, this nut, and move the cable up a little bit so it would pull some more. Chipper's over there. I've been ripping up bamboo. That's gone. Got rid of it. Sold it. That's probably Bob right there messaging me. Trike's in the driveway, just the frame, the body's right next to it. This was the other thing, this is why I stopped. There's a propane heater. I believe it was Husky. Let's see, was it Husky? Ready heater. This thing is nice. I mean, I don't think it's even been used. If it has, it wasn't much, because it's not even stained. But it does have the older style propane gauge on it. I am going to go up the street. There's a gas grill with the big plastic one. Yeah, this thing's got a big plastic, the new type of connector. I'm going to go rip that off with a pair of pliers after I drop my glasses. I'm going to move the heads, get all the stuff off the top of my parts cleaner here, and hopefully pull out the jugs. I got three jugs in there soaking that have been soaking like all winter. And I have checked them. They are okay. Here's the nuts for the top. I'm going to put the stuff away somewhere. Oh, this was the intake manifold. I don't remember if I took pictures. But the powder-coated red, blood red ends are on. The stained black, I did a little stupid fade to silver, the center silver, and then back to black. It looks good. But these are really shiny. Powder coating's got to be the best thing on the planet. And that was my buddy Hank. We did these, months ago now. So just keep that stuff here. Doesn't roll away. Can even move these over here. My biggest fear is that they're gonna fall. Let's get this one. I'll move with the camera so George don't get dizzy. I have a hard time with this camera. I have to go slow because it's actually smaller than a cell phone, and you just get used to whipping it around like this and make people dizzy. So I'm going to go as slow as I can, put some things away. These are cool. I found these in the street one day. I think they're Stanley, but they're really nice pliers. Going up the road, there they were, in the middle of the street. I don't think these are Volkswagen. Put this stuff away. This is that... this is the race bearing thing that someone had used as a spacer for the triple trees, the top springs. That's what we replaced. Bob machined out the ones that I found, drilled them out for me. This is a washer that, I can't think of his name. Rick over in Goffstown gave me. I had one for the top and one for the bottom. Pliers, stupid brush. Clean off the crap. I'm moving it with me, so that's my little junk cart, all kinds of nuts and bolts. Okay, let's unbury the rags here. If I put my camera on like a head cam or something, you wouldn't be able to follow me because my head goes way too fast. And there they are, 1, 2, 3. I'm going to pull them out of the solution and rinse them off with some water, dry them off, I hope. Even some goodies in here too, I'm sure. Oh yeah, look at all the BBs and bearings and stuff I won't be needing because I already have it all. Now let's take these out and let them dry off. Got a little bit of rust, but nothing crazy. I'm gonna have to, don't wanna drop these. I'll put them on the wood. That's one. That's just corrosion. Nope, it's not even that. It's just goop sitting on the side. I'm gonna have to wipe out the insides of these two. I got some goop just from them sitting. The residue sat on the bottom. It's not corrosion, so that's a good thing. Wash that off. And I'm gonna have to go up back and get number three. I mean number four. No broken fins. 85.5 millimeter. Wish the sun was out. I'd have some nice hot water to wash them off. All right, we can close this now. I can use a rag because that stuff stinks. Here's my last good jug. This one is all cleaned up. I have not honed it. I'm gonna put that one right here. I have four pistons back here to get too. I was thinking about this. I don't know what I did with the clips. I might be in trouble. I don't want to drop these, so bear with me. Three, four. Hey, look, another horn. No, that's for the hot rod. No more horns. We've got enough horns. All right. One. Two. Three. And where the hell's the pin? I'm missing a pin. I gotta turn the light on. Hold on, George. Close your eyes. Okay. What a mess. Who the hell lives here? Okay, I was missing a pin. How could I be missing a pin? Ooh, that's not a good thing. Alright, I'm gonna find the pin. Give me a minute. Alright, I found my missing wrist pin here. It just fell behind. These are really, really clean now. I spent a lot of time hand polishing these things with a Scotch-Brite pad, and I just gotta rinse them off. I got a little bit of carbon in the middle. But these are the four original. That's the one that was pitted, but it's just a little bit. These are the four original pistons from the mud buggy. And you can see they're numbered one. Actually, you go by the arrows. You can see the arrow right there. It points towards the front of the engine, I believe it is. I'll have to look that up. Why it matters, I don't know. Maybe the size of the skirts, they both look the same, or the counterweights. I don't know. But they have the arrows. I'm gonna clean them up. I have a hone, but I think it's not a ball hone. It's one of those, the three leg type with the flat stones. Maybe I could use that. I don't see why not. It's what I've used for years. 85.5 millimeter, stock 1600cc Volkswagen Beetle. Dual port. That is dual port. Two ports. Dual port. It's actually raining out right now. Starting to. The Jeep door is open. Cool sight is one toy, his two toys. Work truck. But, alright, I'm going to clean a little bit. I'm going to wash them puppies off and bring them in. Get the parts cleaner fluid off them. Get that goop that's in the bottom out. Wipe them out good. And see if I can find my cylinder hone in there. I know it's in the bottom of the toolbox somewhere. I don't know if it's any good even. I haven't used it in forever. Yeah, that's a good word. Forever.
All right. Well, I went through all my big drawers on the bottom of the toolbox,
and I'm looking, and there it is, right there. Hiding. Now, the safety glasses would be a good idea, too. Oh, boy, I got to dig that puppy out. This was actually the worst one of them all. It sat on in the rain for a night and had a little bit of surface rust on the inside. Now, I haven't sandblasted this one on the outside yet, but I just wanted to see what the hone would do to it. So I did a quick in and out. There's a little grease in the back I haven't cleaned up yet, but it It's got a little stain, but there is no surface edge, anything I can feel on it whatsoever. So, and this isn't one of the, this is actually the one that replaced the jug that was a rotted piece of crap when the whole engine was seized. But I'm going to run this through some gas or something to clean it up good. Let it dry and then sandblast and paint the outside. I got to get rid of this corrosion on here. There's a lot, well, it's actually rust. There's a lot of rust on the surface and the outside. I want it to sit nice and smooth in the jug. Same goes for the back. There's a little bit of rust. And in between the fins, if you remember, this sucker was so full of acorns, it wasn't funny. Actually, this one probably wasn't. This was the one not from the mud buggy engine. This is the extra I had from that engine from Ernie up in Maine. So I got a good jug out of that engine. Actually, I got a couple good jugs out of that engine. I'm cleaning it up. There you go. So it's just goop in the back. What I used was Tool, air tool lubricant. Squirt a little in there and hone it in and out real quick. And I wanted to go in and out real fast and do like a cross hatch. This one I kind of had to break down the rust first. I did it for about a minute. And I don't want to really do it for any more because I'm not machining it. All right, I got two more to do like this. Actually, I got to do all three like this. I don't know where my soft jaws went. I have these yellow things that stick in the jaws to hold the thing. So what I did is I put it on the flat spot and I kept it towards the back so it doesn't break off the precious cooling fins. Okay, three more to go. Okay, we're going to give George a Robin action shot. If he's in here. Now I'm watching where it's scraping, so can't show you that. Going front to back, right on the edge of the jug. I can see it. Ow! They're famous for pinching you too when you're done. Ooh, that's pretty. Alright, I want to do just a little bit more, so I put some more oil in there. Do for about another 30 seconds, and then this one's done. Centered, not go too deep or too far out, or you get in trouble. Okay, crimp them together, don't pull them straight out, you just put a nice big scratch in it. You never put this down in the dirt, on your dirty bench. Let me show you this one. Okay, I gotta wipe it out, of course. Nice, nice little crosshatch pattern. A little bit of stain right there, but nothing you can feel. There's no ridge. Two more to go. I was about to cut into number two here and get rid of these little ridges, and my battery went dead. So I gotta wait for my batteries to charge. My DeWalt drill, Milwaukee drill. Just a little cordless thing. But it works good. This one isn't too bad. Got a little ridge around here. Nothing you can feel, at least not with a human finger, but it's obviously where the ring stop and then come go back down. I had the same kind of little stain on the side, but nothing crazy. Looks good in there, and it'll look even better when it's done, as soon as I find some battery power. Here's a little thing I like to do when I have one of something, when I need two, and I had to make something to replace it. The thing that gets replaced, you take it like this, you put it in your hand, and you pew into the frickin' woods. I can't tell you how many tools are out there either. Wrench breaks, out it goes. You can replace it later. Unless it's a Craftsman, we don't throw our Craftsmans, right? Or Snap-ons or anything like that. Looking good. Here's the jugs. I showed you two pictures. I got a little scratch right there and a little stain. Not too shabby. I haven't touched this one yet. You can see the shiny mirror part of it. This one looks real good. Just need to be, that's water. Just needs to be cross-hatched. And meanwhile, I'm still waiting for battery to charge. Not bad at all for a little lawnmower rebuild, huh? Looks pretty good. There's a little shiny spot at the top. I don't want to mess with it too much. It's obviously where the piston ends and then reverses and goes the other direction. But it looks good. Not bad for a 40-year-old cylinder. I'll give you a little before and after. You can see where the rings stop. It's all shiny until about the last inch and a half of the jug. And up here, you can see where they stop. There's about a 3/8 of an inch off the edge where it's just carbon. And it's all shiny from all the wear and tear over the years. It's like a mirror, so I'm going to break that mirror and rough it all up and put some nice crosshatch in it. And hopefully clean out the carbon on the edge. This is the one I painted already. I didn't hone this one. This was the very end of like last summer. I painted this thing and then that was it. We had nothing but bad weather after that. So, all right. Gonna hone this one.
Here it is. I haven't cleaned it out yet, but I have honed the bejesus out of it.
There's just a little ridge right there inside, but not something you can feel with your finger. It's more stain. But remember, this engine sat since, say Hank's favorite number, 1986. Now, I probably ran a couple years and then it sat with a valve open, a sticky jug. This is one of the original jugs, I can tell, because it's got a little tiny bit of corrosion on one of the fins. It looks good, just got to wipe it out. I'm thinking some carb cleaner will take care of the grease in there too. But all right, well, there I was wiping it all down. And I dropped it. I broke a fin off. So, oh man, what am I gonna? Oops. I think I broke another fin off.
Oh, they didn't break off. Come on, break off. You don't break off too easy, I guess. There you go. That's it. Now it's junk.
Oh, sorry, George. Every time I do a swing, I'm going to say, sorry, George. One, two, three, one left. I was just messing with you. That was an old jug, and it was broken anyway. All right, this is the last one. Got a little bit of goop, a little bit of water, some shiny area. And the tail end where the piston never reached. This is the one I just did, the painted one. Remember the painted one? That's the painted one now. There is a little bit of stain around the edge here, but it seems to be only, I can tell that was the top of the piston because any moisture would have got in there would have made that little groove. Probably a good reason it got stuck. There's somebody texting me. All right, I got one more to go. Yeehaw. Last one's done, little ridge. This one I didn't like too much. Got that ridge all the way around, but the piston don't come up that high. It's obvious the rings must sit there. This one looks good even though it's upside down. That one has a little bit of the ridge. Same thing. They all have about the same. It seems that when the engine sat, it dug a little groove in the edges where the ring sat, because here's your flat spot. This is probably the bottom. Here's your flat spot. It's even worse on the bottom of this one. So what do you do? I don't have $200-$300 for new jugs. And I'm going to blast all the rust off of these three. I'm going to actually go over to Dawn's house and do it. The screen on my blaster is a little foggy. All right, it's a lot foggy. It's actually so foggy you can't see inside, and I don't want to screw these up. So what I'm going to do is pack these things with rags as tight as I can get them, and I'll do a little edge blasting. And I won't get inside the jug. Trust me, I won't get inside the jug. Gonna hit it down here and at an upward angle. That's it. I gotta find some rags and go visit Dawn. Fill this thing with rags. I have more rags than that.
Yeah.
Only gonna do one at a time, so we'll put them all in here. Okay, see you in a bit. Went over to Dawn's and just blasted the heavy stuff off. I'm not going to go crazy with these things. Hell, it's better than 10 pounds of nuts that were in them originally. So they're nice and clean and nut-free, and they're going to be black in a few minutes. But I have one more to do. I got to go clean this one right now. I wasn't going to carry two of them over there and drop one and go, ugh! I haven't broken any yet. Knock on wood. Gonna rinse these out, get the grid out, and paint them. One left to blast. See in a few. Well, it poured out for like a minute, and now the sun's out, so. Point right in the garage, so I am gonna put these suckers in black after I shut that fan off. Make them all nice and pretty. I'm gonna tape off the tops or shove some rags in there. This is a big project. This is a big project. But you take the big part and you break it up in 100 little pieces, and eventually it all goes back together. I hope. Here they are, all painted, high heat black, what is it, Rust-Oleum high heat for barbecue grill. Probably hard to take a picture of these, but use some, what do they call it, just some matey grit, piece of sandpaper, stick it on the top, and go to town. And I painted it good. I mean, it's about a half a can on all three of these, and then a little bit more on number four. I figured he could use a paint job too. We'll give him a second coat, and then these guys will get a nice thick coat. I dusted them, let them dry, and then just soaked them. It's kind of hard to get this stuff wrong. I don't know if you can hear me with the fan, but I'm sweating like a pig. Does a pig sweat? That's a good one. I'm cleaning up. Look at how nice that is. Sexy. But I'm gonna go in. It's been a long day. I really didn't have time to do these, but I made it a point to do them because it was in the back of my head all day. They're drying right in front of my eyes. Look at the paint. I got the fan on them now. Serial numbers where we sandblasted. 85.5 millimeter. I got a little bit of cuck on the corner here from the tape, but I'll worry about that when it dries. Bring you around front. That is it. I am going in. You have a good night. Well, good night, George.